measuring the Chicago Bulls' success, Michael Jordan is the one constant. But it's the play of Scottie Pippen that often separates victories from defeats. Last year, Pippen established his place among the NBA elite as he helped lead the Bulls to their first title. But it wasn't always that way for Scottie Pippen. Some said he didn't have a heart. Remember 2 years ago, the migraine? Others questioned his mental toughness. Could he handle the pressure? But Pippen answered all his doubters. And in this series, he has emerged as the Bulls' barometer. In game one, he elevated them to victory. In game two, Pippen struggled and the Bulls lost. Game three, he led the way for his teammates, propelling the Bulls to a smashing victory. So while Jordan ponders repeat, it's his partner's play that might make this dream come true.
The 1992 NBA Playoffs. Today, Game 4 of the Eastern Conference Finals between the Chicago Bulls and the Cleveland Cavaliers.
A capacity crowd, more than 20,000 turning out of the Coliseum in Richfield. It is a pressure game for the Cavaliers, who do not want to go back to Chicago, trailing 3-1. Hi, everybody. I'm Marv, along with the czar of the tennis writer, Mike Fratello. Now, on Saturday here at the Coliseum in Game 3, it was clearly Michael Jordan as the dominant player, but as the Bulls have witnessed over the past 2 years, if they are to succeed, even if Jordan explodes, they must get a solid game from Scottie Pippen, and Mike, that has certainly been the case in this series to this point.
Well, it becomes quite obvious the further we go into the playoffs, Michael Jordan alone is not enough to bring the Chicago Bulls back to another championship. It takes Pippen's contributions as well. Let's go back and back to the first series in the playoffs against Miami, where the Bulls swept 3-0, Pippen shooting 55%, averaging 24 points per game. In the second series against New York Knicks, which was extended to all seven games, Pippen on a bad ankle, shooting only 40%, scoring 16 points per game, had a very difficult time in guarding Xavier McDaniel. In the current series where the Bulls were up 2-1, Pippen back up, shooting 58%, averaging 26 points per game. So it becomes very obvious that two superstars contributing make it much easier.
And a great concern to the Cavaliers, the condition of their starting point guard, Mark Price, who, as we mentioned on Showtime, is bothered by a stomach virus. He told us he'll give it a shot, but does not feel particularly well. Now, on Saturday in Game 3, Chicago was able to succeed by successfully zeroing in on the two key ingredients for the Cavaliers, Price and center Brad Doherty.
The Bulls' defense focused in on those two players and were very, very good at it. For Mark Price, sure, he has a big concern with the virus, but in game number three, another concern was the fact that Phil Jackson switched Michael Jordan onto him defensively. Jordan at 6 feet, 6 inches tall, a bigger defender. Tough for Price to look in the hole, tough for him to get that jump shot up over the extended arm of Michael Jordan. As for Doherty, the Bulls changed up on him. They were physical, they came with different double teams from different areas on the floor, and the timing was much different. So the feeling here is that the two stars for each team, Pippen, Jordan, Doherty, Price, both must contribute their teams to win.
All right, for more on these two clauses, we'll close in on game time. Let's go over to Ahmad, Rashad.
All right, Marv, I am busy with both block arms, and unlike the way it was before the last game, both block arms relatively quiet because they're both trying to search for that elusive consistency. Now, I talked to Michael Jordan about it. He says that we can talk about it, we can think about it all we want to. The only place we can find it is out on the court. Now, Marv, one other note. I have checked the parking lot. There are no signs of any marshmallows or any cream puffs.
Ahmad, as always, covering all aspects of the story. When we come back, game four of the best of seven Eastern Conference Final. Center. There's Lenny Wilkins, a Hall of Famer. He'll be one of Chuck Daly's assistants for the 1992 U.S. Olympic men's basketball team. The officials, Hugh Evans, Jess Kersey, and Ed F. Rush. We are set for game number four. The Bulls with a 2-1 lead in five back in Chicago on Wednesday night, and we will have it for you here on NBC.